7 Lok Kalyan marks. So I want to quickly take in a word from Payal. What are you witnessing around yourself, Payal? Giriraj Singh, Sarbanand Sonowal, Amit Shah, JP Nadda, Shivraj Singh Chauhan, we believe they have already reached.
Well, it's going to be very difficult for us to actually understand who's reaching from here on, given the fact that there's a cars which are fleeting around us, and this is, we are on the other side of the road to the entrance where the people are supposed to enter. So only when they exit is when we'll know actually who is exiting. That's when we'll get a confirmation. But yes, a lot of cars around me, given the fact that this is the main road, and the police have stopped us from, you know, getting onto the road and witnessing and seeing who's entering as well. So that is something which is there. But we are getting one big news that right now that Ramneet Singh Bittu, who in fact jumped a ship from the BJP, from the Congress to the BJP, he's also got a call in. Remember, he lost his election this time around from Punjab, but the BJP has decided to field him. He's the grandson of Mr. Biyan Singh, and he's been brought to the BJP just very recently, but he's going to be getting a look in into the cabinet, is what we've been told.
Okay, all right. Very interesting that Ravneet Singh Bittu has also been dialed. So that's another interesting name added to the list. Apart from this, we're also learning that Anupriya Patel has left from her residence. She could be seen meeting Rajnath Singh a little while earlier, but whether or not she's left for 7 Lok Kalyan Mart, we'll have to wait a little bit for that. Let me quickly go across to Arunima as well. Arunima, we're picking up from the JDU camp source-based information on what's in line for them. As we've been discussing, that's what's expected. One cabinet portfolio, one MOS berth for the JDU. Are there any conditions that have been put forth by the party though?
Yes, we have been reporting this since yesterday. Now, the topmost sources in JDU have confirmed to us that it will be one cabinet and one MOS. They did not insist for any other portfolio or any conditionality. Like it was being said that railways is something that the JDU is keen on. But topmost sources in JDU said that they have left it to the Prime Minister. They have not put any conditionalities as far as the Union Council and the Union Cabinet is concerned. Their focus is on development of Bihar. Nitish Kumar is expected to go back to Patna tomorrow morning after the oath-taking ceremony. Ceremony ends, you know, this evening. And once he's back in Bihar, top JDU sources tells us that Nitish Kumar will start focusing once again on his project of Bihar's development. He will expect from the Union government, from Prime Minister Modi's government, for help, financial help to develop Bihar. Negotiations will also continue once he reaches Bihar about politically how NDA can shape up in Bihar, how BJP and JDU can combine to help Bihar develop further. So Nitish Kumar, his arrival in Patna tomorrow would lead to a number of meetings, a number of calls to allies there, and there will be continuous back and forth between the Union government and Nitish Kumar there to try and shape Bihar's development. So that seems to be the key focus area. JDU top sources once again underlining that we are not putting any conditions, be it number of cabinet or MOS ranks or the kind of portfolio that is given.
Okay, all right. Very interesting. It's a follow-up question, Arunima. No, now, as far as this national picture is concerned, the JDU doesn't seem to be very aspirational and they're not demanding more as far as representation at the center is concerned. But let's not forget, the emphasis time and again has been on development of Bihar. And in that sense, this may just be a bargaining chip. If we try and deep dive into it for, you know, an ask of a financial package for Bihar, not just that, let's not forget, it's important to watch out for the kind of pre-poll framework we see between the BJP and the JDU in the Bihar Lok Sabha elections as well.
Yes, and you know, we just got a chance to meet Nitish Kumar also. There were a lot of speculations about his health, etc. But he's meeting everybody right now inside Nitish's residence. You will see a continuous stream of visitors, JDU supporters, former JDU MLCs and MLAs who have traveled from Patna, people who were hoping for an audience with Nitish Kumar. He's meeting everybody with a smile on his face. And his message to them is that think about, Bihar, how you can contribute to Bihar growth and development. A very confident Nitish Kumar there. And when we were asking him, or we tried to ask him about what he has in mind as far as alliance or his comeback to the NDA is concerned, he only smiled and said that we have already told the Prime Minister and the speech that he gave at the Central Hall. He said, we've already said that we are with the Prime Minister, we are with NDA, whatever he wants, whatever he envisages, plans, yes, we are fully supporting him. So at the Union level, Nitish Kumar is very clear. We want economic development, yes, as much as anybody else, and we are with the Prime Minister on that. The focus is Bihar. What can you do for Bihar?
Okay, now that we're focusing on the big names, the new inductions, All eyes are on 7 Lok Kalyan. Mark Payal, you gave us a very interesting input that Ravneet Singh Bittu has also received a call. Why this is important is that though he may have jumped ship to the Bharatiya Janata Party, he did suffer a defeat at the hands of the Congress candidate in Ludhiana, Aminder Singh Waring. But the fact that he's been given a call, what does this tell us? How do we look at the overall picture as far as his name is concerned?
Well, as far as the BJP is concerned, last time around the BJP had 2 seats that they were able to win in Punjab, but this time around they've not been able to win much. Punjab is a border state and they don't understand the importance of that. And even when he was in the Congress party, Ravneet Singh Bittu was often seen taking a very nationalistic stance when it came to issues concerning the nation as large. And that's the reason the BJP has decided to award him. He is, comes from a family which has actually laid down its life as far as the country's cause is concerned. And he's been somebody who's been very, very vocal about that as well. So that's why Ravneet Singh Bittu is being rewarded. It will be interesting to see who gives away the Rajya Sabha to get him inside the Council of Ministers, given the fact that you have to at least get elected to either house within the next 6 months. That is there. Of course, we've got another input which is also coming in, the Jitin Prasada. Remember who was a cabinet minister in the Yogi cabinet, has now got a look in. He's going to be taking oath as far as Narendra Modi's cabinet is concerned. He's also just reached Lok Kalyan mark. And a big development coming in from the state of Gujarat. C.R. Patil, sitting member of parliament, multiple time member of parliament, somebody who has led the BJP unit of Gujarat to score that 155 record win, he's getting a look in. He's also going to be reaching the Lok Kalyan mark in a short while from now. That's, of course, Prime Minister Narendra Modi also rewarding the regional leaders who've actually tried to make an impact and make a lot of difference as well. Nobody took C.R. Patil's call very seriously that they would cross 150 in Gujarat, but he has been able to achieve that mark. BJP has 25 out of 26 margin, despite the fact that Purushottam Rupala comments against the Kshatriyas did create a lot of furor. But C.R. Patil was able to lead that charge. And of course, remember, in Surat, the election was declared much before the voting really happened. So C.R. Patil comes in from a very, very experienced background. He's been somebody who's very, very close to the Prime Minister as well. He gets reward finally, because when the expansion really happened, one expected that he would be making the minister. But of course, he's waited his turn. He's been a confidant of the Prime Minister. He's been somebody who's worked very well on the ground as well. So he also is likely to reach the Lok Kalyan mark, residence of the Prime Minister, in just a short while from now. So importantly, Union Cabinet ministers who've been working in the last 2 terms getting rewarded with continuity, and of course new people who've created an impact in the regionals also getting a chance in here as well. So it's going to be quite a blend of old and new faces that Prime Minister Narendra Modi is looking at.
Absolutely. We started with Ravneet Singh Bittu. Remember, though he did suffer a defeat at the hands of the Congress candidate in Ludhiana constituency after having jumped ship to the Bharatiya Janata Party, the victory margin was not all that great for the Congress winner. It was about 20,942 votes, which is not all that much. So all of those factors perhaps kept in mind. Also, how much importance do the regional players need to be given? That's also being calculated as we speak. Payal, I'm coming back to you in just a minute. A lot of developments coming in. We're learning of more names who've arrived at 7 Lok Kalyan Mar, including Chirag Paswan. He, remember, spoke extensively to CNN News 18 and he said that, "I'm more than grateful already that the Prime Minister allowed my party to contest on 5 whole seats, which I managed to win for the NDA." So he's been more than grateful. Now, the sense, Aman, one is trying to get from the kind of reactions that have come in from everybody who's contributed to this defeat, to this victory of the NDA and the coming together of the NDA, is that we're more than happy with what we have. We want to support this government fully and we want to ensure 5 successful years.
Absolutely, and that has been the sentiment from the JDU and the TDP, in fact, from day one. I am hearing that in the first meeting itself, the TDP and the JDU had made it clear that they have no specific demands. All they care for is that the Narendra Modi should have a very, very compassionate, a very, very helpful approach for the states of Andhra Pradesh and Bihar respectively, because Chandrababu Naidu was of the opinion that, Jagan Mohan Reddy had really left the coffers empty and he had made big promises to the people in this campaign, Mr. Naidu had, and he is looking for center support to build Amravati, his dream project as the state capital, to help in the dam irrigation projects and to help him fulfill the promises that he has made to people. Same goes for the Nitish Kumar, in Bihar, which has been awaiting infusion of extra funds. That is one reason that Nitish Kumar also returned to the NDA fold a few months back after ditching the RJD. And Nitish Kumar also has been somebody, who made no specific demands. Yes, they are getting one full cabinet minister in Mr. Lalan Singh and one MOS post in Mr. Ramnath Thakur. But clearly, the bigger focus seems to be a part of a strong, decisive government at the center, which helps.